false prophets are prophets of a false god, an idol, or those who claim to speak for the true God, but do so falsely. King Ahab kept 400 of these false prophets hired to tell him what he wanted to hear. In the New Testament, we have many warnings against false prophets. Jesus taught, "Beware of false prophets who come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are ravenous wolves." Then he added that, "In the end times, false Christs and false prophets will arise and will perform great signs and wonders so as to deceive, if possible, even the elect." Revelation tells of a false prophet who will arise in the tribulation and deceive people throughout the world. Listening friend, the Bible warns us against false prophets who claim to speak in the name of God. To avoid being deceived, we must always test the spirits whether they are from God. In 1 John chapter 4 verse 1, it says, "Beloved, do not believe every spirit, but test the spirits to see if they are from God, because many false prophets have gone out into the world." John warned against believing every spirit. We must never assume that every spiritual experience and every demonstration of spiritual power is from God. We must test spiritual experiences and phenomena to see if they are truly from God.
Whatever you do right now, don't you stop tithing. Don't you stop sowing offerings.
And the day will come, you'll walk out of it. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Now is the time to call for the return on your tithing and on your giving and your sowing over the years. Standing in the office of the prophet of God, I execute judgment on you, COVID-19.
Oh, that must.
COVID-19.
COVID-19.
I blow the wind of God.
The wind of God.
On you.
On you.
You are destroyed forever.
I was shocked when I found out who the biggest failure in the Bible actually is. The biggest one in the whole Bible is God.
It proves you. You have to approve yourself. 99.9% of people are not bad people. They may make poor choices, but deep down, they've got a good heart.
Joel Osteen says that one thing he can assure us is that 99.9% of people are not bad people. Well, what does the Bible have to say about this? Apostle Paul seems to think differently. He says, "There is none righteous, not even one. There is none who does good, no, not one."
Say, most people are beaten down enough by life. They already feel guilty enough. They're not doing what they should do, raising their kids. We can all find reasons. So I want them to come to Lakewood or our meetings and be lifted up to say, you know what? I may not be perfect, but I'm moving forward. I'm doing better. And I think that motivates you to do better.
I spent a lot of time in India with my father. And, I don't know all about their religion, but I know they love God. And I don't know. I'd have to, I've seen their sincerity. So I don't know.
Of course, I believe in Christ as the Savior and all. But, I think, too, Glenn, I've spent a lot of time in India. I've been with a lot of Hindu people. They're nice, kind, people that love God as well.
No. Hindus do not love God because they do not know God.
The word repentance, like Joel said, is from the Greek word metanoia, which literally means change your mind. And every time, like Joel or me preaching the word, without using the word repentance sometimes, but people's minds are being changed all the time. From thinking this way negatively to thinking positively. From depression to having a positive expectation of good. Repentance is going on all the time in Joel's church, in my church, and hopefully in your church as well. And you don't have to have this breast-beating shout, "Oh, Jesus, Jesus."
Boy, that Jesse the Planet, he's doing good. And we ain't used to give our tithe over there. We went to a church, and they need it more. Uh-oh! And I'm not against giving to the poor. Listen. Uh-oh, you just changed the rate of exchange on the tithe. Yeah, but I gave it a tithe. Yeah, but you turned it into alms.
I'm going to say something going to knock your lights off. God has the power to take life, but he can't. He got the power to do it, but he won't. He's bound. He can't. He says death and life is in the power of whose tongue? Yours. You ready for this? You want something to knock your lights off? You choose when you live You choose when you die. Death and life's in the power of your tongue.
Friends have frank and open conversations with each other. I've done that with the Lord. I've had the Lord say, Jesse, I've had God come tell me, say, this is what I'm going to do. I've had the Lord literally say, what do you think about this? God has asked me for my opinion. I said, well, Lord, since you asked, maybe I'm doing it. He said, no, we can talk frankly. What do you think? I said, well, I don't think you ought to do that. He said, why you don't think I ought to do that? I said, well, you know, I know you know people more than I do, but you know, Lord, if you just let me do a little bit more work on this individual, I think we can get them to you. He says, okay, go ahead. Do what you have to do. And I tell you what, the Bible says he who wins souls is wise.
Yes, and he who thinks he can counsel God is a fool.
Zenka, Zenka, Zenka kaduparaka daya baba, berakanduria ndebedea, zakida, rombaria anduria kataya, zepaka dia aro pakuta, lerende pakadaya satuba, mekarudie nemese.
Right there.
Lindre enteveato, rukava de desta akra, radaya makida. Remakupa tidaya, rakata la masata. Enter into another realm. Experience kazi baturia makopa. Zaka, zaka. Be overshadowed by the Spirit of God. Zakata la mayaka. Nekaya paba tididibia bakatosh Indrovakida nemese Kiranda labaku. Everybody says sex before marriage is a sin, right? Mm-hmm. Show me one verse that says that.
God doesn't care about your sin anymore.
The biggest lie you are ever told. Is that if it doesn't line up with scripture, it's not from God.
It's a sin. But it implies, based on the morals of Judeo-Christian beliefs or the morals, godly morals, that these things are not a good thing to do, but not necessarily sin, but it can lead you into a sinful path. Like an example, everybody says sex before marriage is a sin, right? Show me one verse that says that. There is no verse that says that. There is no explicit verse that says that. Yeah. You know me, I'll tell you the real. I'm not going to hide. I'll tell you the truth.
Yeah.
There's no verse that explicitly...